I'm here at the Fortune Gym in Los Angeles. Standing near me is boxing sensation Paul Wallet, 27-1. And he came to Los Angeles to fight Cesar Chavez Jr. But that fight is not going to happen. So you're a little disappointed.
Well, Chavez won't fight, but you're fighting another fight from Mexico. Is 18-1.
We haven't agreed to that fight yet. I mean, I came here to fight Chavez Jr. Now, if he wants to be a coward about it and cry and then say things that he's sick, I know he's just fat, can't make weight. El Gordo.
Well, maybe he is sick. I don't know.
He ain't sick.
But let's say he is sick, because I don't know if he's not. But yeah. It happens. It's
for
boxing.
Third time.
Just what my manager said. My manager, Ivan Ivory, said, every time he sees my last, hears my last name, pees his pants. All right, that's what's going on.
So growing up, who did you look up to in the world of boxing?
Oh, I love Frazier, Tyson, obviously guys like that, you know. Duran, I even, you know, used to look up to Chavez's father. The guy was a real man, you know, a legend, real fighter. Son, not so much.
How did you achieve that record?
27-1.
27-1, how did you achieve that?
Through a lot of hard work, you know what I mean? A lot of training. Obviously something that Chavez ain't doing.
You're of Polish descent.
Back in the
70s, the Polacks ruled the Olympians, ruled the Olympics.
Yeah, that's right. The White Hawks, we warriors. We're real men. You know what I'm saying? And you, as a Mexican, that's pretty sad. As a Mexican, because I know Mexicans are hardworking.
Thomas Adamek?
There you go.
What do you think about him? Isn't he also in New Jersey, in the area?
He's fighting actually December 9th. Prudential Center.
You ever trained with him?
I've been at the gym, with him, but he trains in Jersey City, actually. I train in North Bergen.
The Raging Bull.
The Raging Bull?
Yeah.
Paul the Raging Bull Wallet.
Yeah.
Don't mess with him.
No, nobody mess with him.
I used to cover rodeos. Those bulls are out of control, man. They all just snap in 1 second.
Yeah. That is why Chavez don't want to fight him, because this is the third time. All the time when he heard of Pawala, he don't want to fight. We don't know why.
All our action, not stop.
That's your style?
That's right.
You just come in?
That's it, man.
What do you guys, what can you tell me about him?
He's a tough guy. He's a hard worker.
As a fighter, how tough is it to pick up a fight a week before where they say, hey, we need you to step up to the plate?
Listen, normally we would do it, but like I said, we came here to fight Chavez. So that's what we're here for.
You agree?
What?
You agree?
Yeah, I agree on what you said. We came
We've been looking to fight Chavez all summer. This is the third time it's not happening.
Really?
Something's going on. September 11th, he pulled out. Before that, he pulled out. So you do the math.
So if you could pick three fighters, who would you want to go with? If you could choose three fighters to face in the ring.
Chavez Jr.
That's it.
We want him.
Any message to your fans? Because, you know, the Polish people love boxing.
Yeah, thanks for supporting me. It ain't my fault, man. This guy. You know, man, I'm here. I came down last night. You know what I'm saying?
Say something Polish.
You speak Polish?
Oh, yeah.
Really?
Dziękuję wszystkim za support. Nie moja wina, to jest kurde tego Chavesa. Ja mówiłem, on jest gówniarz, to jest dupek. Jak mówię, on się boi mnie. On się mnie boi, bo ja go zniszczę w ringu. Every opportunity, last Wednesday, I took to fight short notice. You know, I was ready to fight. You know, hopefully the fight's gonna happen. I don't know what's gonna happen with this guy. We'll see.
There you have it. Paul Wallet from the Fortune Gym in Los Angeles. I'm Ellie Sekback reporting.